So here is a list of the potential positive things that can happen when you block certain receptors. Block D2 receptors, you will have an antipsychotic, an anti-manic, and an anti-aggression medicine. Block D3, you may have improvement in negative symptoms and cognition. Alpha-2 adrenergic, you may have an antidepressant there. 5-HT7 may have an antidepressant activity there. Hey, these are good things. Maybe this will work out. But with the good comes the bad. These very same receptors, when they're blocked, can also lead to adverse events. So with D2, we know extrapyramidal symptoms, akathisia, ultimately tardive dyskinesia, increased prolactin, alpha-1 adrenergic, postural hypotension, alpha-2 adrenergic, increased blood pressure. So not everything is perfect here. We do know that histaminergic antagonism is probably not a good thing. I can't think of really something that's advantageous here, but perhaps sleep induction, but it's not worth the cost of sedation and weight gain. So with the good comes the bad, and we have to have a balance. The tricky thing about antipsychotics, though, is that you can't really predict exclusively based on these receptor binding profiles. So when you're told of a new drug and you're given a list of receptors that it binds to, you cannot really faithfully predict what will happen for sure. What you need to base your decision on is the clinical trial results. The proof of the pudding is in the tasting, essentially.